I mean, I knew I was gonna take the last shot. You know, coach sent everybody to the baseline. I kind of struggled a little bit throughout the game, but you know, the team kept us in it and kept my confidence high. I had full confidence in the shot, and it went down. So, got the win.
Rondel, how about the team performance today? What'd you think? What was the vibe today for you?
Coming into this game, we saw it as a great game going into Big 12 play. You know, something that give us a little glimpse of what it's going to be like night in, night out. And today was the battle today. So kudos to our teammates and our coaching staff for getting prepared for this game.
All right, members of the media, if you have questions for Rondel Walker or Cade Cunningham, please click raise hand and we'll try and get to everybody. Again, please address the question to the person who you want to answer it. Our first question is going to come from Jacob Unruh from the Oklahoman. Go ahead, Jacob.
Cade, on that final shot, was that kind of what the play was? What was the play there?
I don't know what coach called. I just knew come down to score. So, that was pretty much what my mindset was. I just knew I had to score the ball, man. So thank God it went in.
The Dennis is kind of their marquee defender. To hit it over that, what does that mean to you to kind of get that over a guy that hangs his hat on defense?
He can't hear you for real.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you better.
All right, sorry. I'm actually right behind you guys. Hi. That's their best defender at Wichita State. To hit it over a guy like that, what does that mean for you this early in your career, a guy that hangs his hat on defense?
I didn't really pay too much attention to who was in front of me. You know, he really did play great defense the whole game. You know, and the Wichita State team, you know, they played really well throughout the game, but they gave us a good battle. So, kudos to them. But, you know, I didn't really worry too much about the defender. I just knew I had to make a shot.
Were you frustrated at all with your offensive game today?
Not really. I know there's games you're going to make shots. There's games, you know, the ball won't go in as much. It was hard for me to be mad because my teammates, you know, they stepped up and, you know, they just continued to show that we have, you know, great pieces throughout the team. And, you know, we played a great game today.
I've asked you about your ability to close games. How do you stay patient on a day where shots aren't falling?
I put in so much work. I've spent so much time in the gym. I've got up so many shots that, you know, a couple don't go through. I'm not really too worried about it. I know I put too much work in for it to stay that way. So, you know, shooting the next shot with confidence is the best thing you can do, and that's what I did.
And Rondel, what did you kind of see in that last play?
We all knew it was going to happen. You know, we all knew who was taking the last shot. It's going to be a make, so we're still going to crash and went through. Our next stop after that was to get a stop.
Awesome. Thanks, Rondel. Thanks, Cade.
Our next question is going to come from Marshall Scott of Pistols Fire. Go ahead, Marshall.
Yeah, Cade, I guess there was a pretty long timeout before their last free throws and then your shot. Kind of what were you guys talking about in that timeout? Was that more of a defensive kind of talk there?
What's timeout you talking about?
Right before they hit free throws, they hit the two free throws and then you came down and hit the game winner.
I think the biggest thing, you know, making sure we got a good shot on offense and then just closing the game, closing out possessions with rebounds and keeping them in front of us. And we closed out the game pretty well. So that was the biggest thing I was happy of is, you know, how disciplined we all stayed, and we got to stop it there.
Okay. And you shot just two field goal attempts in the second half. Was that a conscious effort on you to not force things, or kind of what went into the mindset of that?
I just, you know, shot the shots that they gave me. There was a couple times I kind of tried to force the issue, which caused me to turn the ball over. But, you know, they helped a lot, and my teammates were open. And, you know, I have a ton of trust in my teammates. I know they're going to make shots. And so, yeah, that was pretty much the main thing.
Gotcha. And then for Rondel, Isaac, he seemed to just, you know, really kill it on the offensive glass in particular tonight. What does that say about him that he's able to, like, kind of keep you guys afloat if you guys are struggling from shooting early?
Isaac is just a versatile player. You know, he takes what the game gives him. You know, he feeds off what we need. So, we need offensive rebounds or any rebound, any assist, he's that guy for us. So, anything we need, he takes it upon himself to do his best effort to do whatever we got to do to get a win. And today, we got it at a high level today, and the outcome was a win for us.
All right, appreciate it, guys.
We'll go back to Jacob Unruh from the Oklahoman. Go ahead, Jacob.
Hey, Rondel, how do you guys feel like you responded to some of that adversity today? This is kind of the first, like, real road test other than Marquette, and there's fans here. It got kind of loud at times. How do you guys feel like you responded to that?
I feel like we responded pretty well at the time. You know, we kept the lead the whole second half, right? Yeah, we were never down.
I don't think so.
Yeah, we always kept the game close. We talked it out throughout everything. We kept to stay within our team, you know, count on each other. And today we just, yeah, we stuck to the game plan and it led us to a W.
I feel like that's kind of an advanced step for you guys being such a young team.
Yeah, for sure. Just weather and respond together, you know, don't let one person stick out, like, and everybody, like, count on each other and come together for a win.
And for you today too, Rondel, you had that same energy, came in. You're really aggressive that first half. Was that a conscious effort on your part or what?
I just took what the game gave me. You know, every game is different. And today, I just took my opportunities to the fullest. And my teammates did a great job giving me the ball. And I just did my best to put it to the net.
And, Cade, I don't know that we've got to ask you about what you think of the way Rondell's played through six games now.
I mean, I've known Rondel. I played AU with Rondel. So, you know, I think I already knew what he was going to bring. I think it was just, you know, the fans and Oklahoma State fans and stuff like that that didn't really know. So it was no surprise to me. I'm glad, you know, he got the opportunity to come in and play huge minutes. And, you know, I knew he would do nothing but take advantage of that and, you know, not use it for granted. So he's coming in hooping, and you know, I can't ask for anything else.
And I'm going to go ahead and ask you, just because I know it's a big week coming up with TCU and Texas, for you personally, you got Mike Miles and Greg Brown. What do you think about facing those guys next week?
It's going to be fun. You know, me and Rondel, we played with both of them last year at AAU. So, you know, it's definitely going to be a fun time playing against them. But friends off the court, for sure.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Hey, Dell, I got one last question for you. So, going into this game, there was a whole lot of talk, a whole lot of chatter about three-point defense. Second half of this game, you hold Wichita State to 1-for-14 from three on their home floor. What changed? What was different?
We just knew that it came a point in time to where we can't let that happen every game. So that was definitely a primary focus. And they had two guards, but that's what they primarily wanted to do. And in order to win games, you got to try to shut out what they want to do, take what they want to do and make them do what we want to do. And we made them drive and make them make difficult plays that they didn't want to make. And today we just stuck to the game plan really well. And that was the outcome of the game.
How much of that is mentality versus ability? You know what I'm saying?
It's definitely all basically so like a heart thing. You know, the coaches do a great job of drawing up a game plan for us. And that's tough. I'm sorry. The coaches do a great job of us drawing up a game plan, and we just got to go stick to it. And they can coach all they want off the court, but on the court, it's up to us to execute the game plan. And it's just the mentality that we have in our heads that we got to do what we got to do on the defensive end. Everything else is taken care of itself. So.